Severe pneumonia affects 4.2 million children, leaving them with low oxygen levels. Severe pneumonia affects about 4.2 million children below the age of 5 in 124 low and middle-income countries, leaving them with critically low oxygen levels each year. This finding was documented by UNICEF, Clinton Health Access Initiative, or CHAI, Save the Children, and Murdoch Children's Research Institute, or MCRI. Pandemic-related disruptions to health services jeopardized the battle against pneumonia, with more than 800,000 children below 5 years dying from the disease each year. Further, severe pneumonia leaves over 22 million young children in low- and middle-income countries each year and kills more than malaria, measles, and diarrhea combined. Henrietta Fore, a UNICEF executive director, shared that we must not lose sight that pneumonia continues to kill over 2,000 young lives a day, even while the world struggles with the pandemic and its impacts on the most vulnerable. Hence, medical oxygen can help save more children's lives, she added. When accompanied by antibiotics, medical oxygen could save the lives of children with severe pneumonia. But in many places, oxygen to treat a child with severe pneumonia over 3 to 4 days can cost at least 30 to 45 pounds or approximately $39 to $59. For the poorest families, that amount is a huge barrier to access to treatment. That is if the child can be treated at a health facility with functioning oxygen and trained health workers. Unfortunately, these are often lacking in poorer countries. Poorer countries suffer from a huge lack of oxygen systems and supplies prior to the COVID-19 pandemic. However, surging needs during the current health crisis have exacerbated these shortages. In much of Africa, fewer than 1 in 5 get the treatment the children need, said Save the Children CEO Inger Ashing. Most of them die from exhaustion, as their bodies are deprived of the oxygen they need to recover. Fortunately, oxygen can be produced locally at a reasonable cost. Ashing emphasized that while the world continues to bolster their oxygen supply to save people from COVID-19 and pneumonia, oxygen supply must be sustainable, accessible to the hardest to reach, and be free. Presently, the pandemic has scaled global efforts to improve oxygen supply systems. For example, the WHO and partners distributed 30,000 oxygen concentrators to countries all over the globe. UNICEF has also delivered more than 15,000 concentrators to over 90 countries. According to Dr. Ian Barton, CHAI CEO, helping states build resilient systems to provide oxygen reliably and effectively will save lives during the pandemic and treat patients sustainably in the future.